Hey, guess who?
Phil!
And we're reading what?
First John!
Which teaches three things?
True teaching, true living, true loving!
Wonderful! And we've finished chapter 4, which means it's time to start chapter...
7!
No, 5!
5! I rounded up.
And guess how many chapters there are in 1 John?
7!
9?
33?
Nope! There are 5, which means...
We're starting the last chapter!
Oh my goodness! Where has the time gone?
I know, it's gone pretty fast, hasn't it? Going through a whole book of the Bible. So, chapter 5. Who can read the first 5 verses? Emily?
I am on it. Everyone who believes that Jesus is the Christ is God's child. The person who loves the Father also loves the Father's children. How do we know that we love God's children? We know because we love God and we obey His commands. Loving God means obeying His commands. And God's commands are not too hard for us. Everyone who is a child of God has the power to win against the world. It is our faith that wins the victory against the world. So, the one who conquers the world is the person who believes that Jesus is the Son of God.
We're gonna conquer the world with Jesus' power! Is that what that means?
Sort of. Let's jump into the middle of that. Loving God means obeying His commands. We've talked about this before, right?
Right. It doesn't mean we have to follow all the rules Israel had to follow. The no beard shaving and the no pork eating and all that.
Nope. It means we love God and we love our neighbors.
And loving others means we live good lives. We make others more important. We help those who need help. This shows we love God. But we also show we love God by believing what is true and rejecting what is not true. What is false.
Does this go back to the sneaky snake and the whispers of the world?
It does indeed. Remember, we have an enemy who tells us lies. Lies about God, and also lies about ourselves. That God could never love us. That we'll only get what we want if we hurt others. If we're selfish and greedy. Those are the whispers of the world that God tells us to reject.
I reject you, worldly whispers!
Very good, Emily.
You kinda startled me.
Sorry, I was in the moment.
If we read on, it says, God's commands are not too hard for us. Everyone who is a child of God has the power to win against the world. It is our faith that wins the victory against the world. So we have the power to win against the world.
Against the worldly whispers of the world?
Against the worldly whispers of the world that want to drag us down and steal our joy and destroy our fellowship with God. And where do we get the power to win against the world?
It is our faith that wins the victory against the world. What's faith?
I know. I was watching something on the TV, and they said faith is believing things that aren't true. So we have to believe things that aren't true.
That is totally not what faith is.
Oh, was that a worldly whisper of the world?
That was a worldly whisper of the world. Some people today want us to believe that faith is something only silly religious people have, and it means you believe in things that aren't true. But that isn't faith. Believing in something that isn't true is delusion, not faith.
So then what's faith?
It's very simple. Faith is relying on the promise of someone or something.
Explain.
Okay, say you have a fish tank full of fish. These are very fancy fish, and they're hard to take care of.
Ooh, fancy fish. I like this story already.
You want to go on vacation for a whole month, but you can't go unless you can find someone to take care of your fancy fish. Your friend says, I can take care of your fancy fish. I promise.
How big are these fish?
That's not really important.
Are they big enough to eat your friend?
No, they're small, fancy fish.
Okay, so what do?
So you say to your friend, I hear what you say, but then you don't go on the vacation. You don't let your friend take care of the fish. Did you put your faith in your friend?
Well, if faith means to rely on someone's promise, I'd say no. You didn't rely on his promise because you didn't let him take care of the fish.
Exactly. You can hear what your friend says and maybe even think he could take care of your fish. Maybe. But until you hand him your fish and walk away, until you rely on him to keep your fish alive, you haven't put your faith in him.
Got it. So, are we the fish in this scenario? And who's Jesus? The tank? The fish food?
Hang on. Back to John. It is our faith that wins the victory against the world. So the one who conquers the world is the person who believes that Jesus is the Son of God. We have the power to conquer the world when we trust that Jesus really is the Son of God, and that because he is God's Son, he can bring us before God, into fellowship with God, without us getting punished for our sins.
Like someone who comes before the king who has no right to be there.
Exactly.
So in your fish story, Jesus is the friend
who promises he can keep your fish alive.
And the fish are our eternal happiness, our relationships with God forever.
There you go. Jesus is saying to us, trust me with your eternal happiness. I will bring you into the party with my Father, the King, without punishment, as an adopted son or daughter. And all we have to do is say, I believe Jesus is who he says he is, and that he can do what he says he can do. And I'm going to live like it's true.
Wow, we learned so much about faith today, and the care in feeding of fish.
Hey, is this why Christians put fish on their car bumpers?
No, not at all. See you next time.